today. From MetLife Stadium in New Jersey, this is the NFL on EA Sports. We'll see Zach Wilson and the New York Jets taking on Sam Howell and the Washington Commanders.
That's an afternoon probably best suited for skating in Central Park, but we're across the river and we are in for a cold one at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one, as it'll be the Washington Commanders taking on the New York Jets. Joey Sly, the kicker, stands ready.
And we are underway from MetLife Stadium.
And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25.
So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over.
They're led out by a former number two overall pick in the draft from BYU at Zach Wilson.
And what was really attractive about Zach Wilson coming out of college, coming out of BYU, his ability to create and make plays when many people thought they didn't exist. But what's been even better is watch him improve in the pocket, able to hit the back foot, make the right read, and the right throws.
Now the second-year man back from injury, it's Breece Hall.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that gain.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line.
They'll go again with Hall.
Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five.
They'll need five on this play to move the sticks.
From the gun on third down, Wilson.
And check down complete to Hall.
And this will not be enough. On third and five, he only gets three.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be fourth and short.
On fourth down, here's the veteran Thomas Morstead to punt for the Jets.
And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback.
Here are the Commanders for their first drive of the game. And bringing them out, the former Tar Heel, second-year pro Sam Howell.
I tell you what, when he is on schedule for that week, secondaries take notice because you've got to stay alert back there on every snap. A truly powerful arm, one that's capable of challenging any level of the defense on any given play. That's why so many scouts preach arm talent when preparing for the NFL draft. A quarterback with arm strength to make every throw in the book, he's an asset to have in any offense.
Howell and the Commanders come up now, first and 10
at the 20. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and it'll be second down.
His first pass attempt of the game, Charles, and the pass rush was right there to hit him. But no fear, he delivered an accurate ball. Nice catch.
And you never want to see your quarterback getting hit, but it also sends a message to the rest of the team when he's able to take that shot and still deliver downfield. Showing a little toughness, and the team rallies around him. This could really help him on their drive.
Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
From the gun on third down, Howell. And this pass broken up. Well, the contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Tressway on fourth down is sent out to punt. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Had a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Back onto the field come the New York Jets for their second drive. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. And it may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here too after a good stop. Now Hall to start the drive. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Boy, you go 3 and out on your first drive, and that's not the way you want to start this drive either. Doesn't seem like they're really into it just yet.
No, first 4 plays, you don't want to call it a disaster, but not looking very sharp. So now they have to contend with 2nd and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Straight ahead is Hall. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
You got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
From the gun, it's Wilson. That is caught. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
That's a big gainer on that play. And from experience, I can tell you, that's where defensive backs will come into the huddle and say, guys, how about some pass rush? But you're going to say it nicely, because those big guys up front, they don't like being criticized very much. Quarterbacks in this league, you know they'll pick you apart if you give them time like that to find receivers downfield.
Here we go, D, get off the field. 57 to Mike. Mike, 57. Play action, it's Wilson. And an off-balance throw there, and it's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, that's a defensive coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
Now it's 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. He finds his man complete. It's Wilson. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 42.
The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
A handoff for Hall. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here. 10 more there and another first down. The first drive this unit had, they punted. This drive much more polished, just looking crisper, aren't they, moving the ball?
Maybe the first drive was a little bit of a wake-up call. Probably a little bit angry that they had to punt the ball away the first time they had it. Got motivated, got to the sideline, said, okay, let's not let that happen here as we take over again.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. On first and 10, it's Hall. And he's going to take this one down to the 25. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. We're scoreless after one. Second quarter now from MetLife Stadium. The Jets with the football here as they've got it with a second and 3 forthcoming. To throw is Wilson. This pass out wide to Hall. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive. Ninth play coming up here on this drive. This is 3rd and a yard. On the counter, it's Hall. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Throwing is Wilson. Throw left side complete. That's Wilson. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. He's got Wilson, and that's a Jets touchdown. A 7-yard touchdown grab, and the Jets post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. He's got it, and the Jets lead 7-0. So that one a long 11-play drive. And Garrett Wilson capped things off with a touchdown grab.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick.
This taken in at the goal line. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Commanders going to retake the field for drive number two.
They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. Now the second-year man from Alabama, it's Brian Robinson. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Samuel going to go in motion right. Second down, Howell now.
Open man is Samuel, complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. First catch for him. It's good for a dozen and a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. And it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Oh, here's a fake on the jet sweep and a give to Robinson.
Showing off the quick feet that time and getting forward for a pickup of 3 yards.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. From the 48-yard line, here's second down at 7. Out of the gun, it's Howell.
Middle of the field, he's got McLaurin. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 36. A new set of downs after a strong pickup of 16 yards.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Powell.
Over the middle, complete to Samuel. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
Second and 7. Howell, he'll look to throw it.
And it's a fumble, and the Jets have recovered.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Here's the Jet offense now. They head out to take over. Still more than a minute to go, so there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time, but they have 3 timeouts at their disposal as well, so that changes everything that you're doing here. Without those timeouts, you can only work the sidelines, hoping to get out of bounds. Here, the middle of the field's still available because you can call timeout and regroup.
Following the fumble recovery, it's Wilson. That'll be complete to Alan Lazard. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. The end result, 21 yards.
That's a nice throw there, and he's obviously feeling pretty good because, remember, he had a touchdown pass on the last drive, and here he comes out throwing again. and they wind up getting good yardage and a first down right out of the gate.
Midfield now. Here's Wilson. Oh, the Commanders are going to get there as he's taken down. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Now, following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Now Wilson, looking middle, and it's incomplete.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Hall on a give up the middle. A strong running. And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Now the veteran Thomas Morstead on to punt it away. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. Washington going to go on offense now late in this first half. A slim deficit here in a one-possession game. Not much time left, obviously. We'll see if they can march this down the field, at least get three and take some momentum into the locker room. Throwing on first down here. Quick hitter here. It's complete. The Commanders going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line. Second and a yard. Faking the handoff, Howell winds up and lets it go for Samuel. And got his man, complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. 36 yards on the play.
We always talk about the guy who paid off the play, don't we? The guy who caught it or ran it. But how about the elements that go into making a big play? This one in particular, able to scan the field. Pocket held up nicely. What a terrific job by the offensive line. The route well run, and the football right on the money.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. Sly able to put this one through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So that kick gives them their first points of the game, CD, and it comes on the third drive, but hopefully for them that's a spark that gets that offense going.
Yeah, and I would say if you're the offensive play caller, as you look at your sheet, you're trying to find that part on there that unlocks bigger points. They've struggled with a few drives so far, finally got three out of it. How do you find the end zone? That's what he's searching for now.
So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. On the return is Gibson.
F-E-C-F-E.
So we've hit halftime here at MetLife Stadium with the home team, the Jets, leading this one. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. We were treated to a strong first half from the former number two overall pick, Zach Wilson. He has a touchdown pass, and that amounted to the only touchdown of the game for either team thus far.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. Washington down on the scoreboard, but they are getting the football first here, and we are back underway on EA Sports. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. The Commanders up first on offense as we begin this third quarter. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Oh, there's plenty of traffic waiting for him up the middle. But give him credit, he tried barreling through anyway. They're fortunate to get a yard out of that one.
Still 9 yards to go on second down from the 27. Gibson here running out of the gun. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a third and about 4.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
This now a third and 4. Gibson again. Runs through the contact, and he will have a first down here at about the 40. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
To the air on first and 10. Throws the out route and completes it to Samuel. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Second down, Hal back to pass. And this one nearly intercepted. Boy, that would have been a great time for their first pick. But instead, it's third down. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart, and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. And Hal will throw it. Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete.
And so many times we look at the opening drive of the third quarter as a tone setter, and many coaches do emphasize it. And that's a strong performance there defensively to force the incompletion, and more importantly, force a quick punting situation.
Here's Tressway now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this will be out of bounds, and they spotted it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. So here's the Jets offense now as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Now a late signee let go by Minnesota in June. It's Dalvin Cook. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
On second down, a run with Hall. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. Now they're staring at a third and 8. That last play, backwards a yard.
Well, it's almost football 101 that you preach to your safeties. Don't let anyone get behind you. You're the last line of defense. But he didn't let the play come to him. He went to the play. How about that read and recognition and finishing off that one behind the line of scrimmage?
They'll see about converting this third and 8. There's Wilson to throw. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
This is certainly a team that has proven it likes to target its backs through the air, and defensively, they were aware of that and certainly were prepared on that throw.
Here's Thomas Morstead now, standing right on his own 5-yard line. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. They start on the ground with Robinson here. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got him pinned down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down. That's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
And this is going to double their room to maneuver, able to get it from the 5 to the 10-yard line.
No, that wasn't an explosive run. That wasn't one that took it all the way to the house. But, boy, for a team that's had trouble running it the entire game, that's the kind of run they need, hopefully, to get themselves kick-started.
Robinson will try to pick it up. And he will have the first down here as he's up to the 15. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. They'll throw on first down. Here's Howell. Got this complete to Jahan Dotson. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. The catch and run, good for 24 yards. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here at MetLife Stadium. It's Washington with the football, but trailing here as we begin quarter number four. A couple of first downs have them to the 40 now on first and 10. Shotgun handoff to Gibson. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
On second down, here's Gibson again. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. 15 yards the pickup, first down Washington.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
So in jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 43. Robinson up the middle. And he's able to carve out about 6 there, down to the 37.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Second down and 4. Back to throw. Howell. Looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And McLaurin going to pick up a Commander's first down as the tackle is made at the 28-yard line. First down, Howell. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Second down and a little more than a yard here. Now Howell. Again, he'll find Samuel for the completion. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Commanders football as we get back to it. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. They'll come up first and 10 here. Throwing here, Howell. Catch here, left side, Thomas.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage.
Here comes second down. Here's Howell. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
The noise is getting deafening. Here's third down and three. Looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. Touchdown, Washington. A 5-yard touchdown catch, and the Commanders put together a fourth quarter drive to take the lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it, and this is indeed up to a 3-point lead. So that one, a 13-play drive in total. And it's finished off by a Terry McLaurin touchdown. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. So here is Wilson and the Jets. Down 10-7. A little over 80 ticks to go. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. He's back to throw. A short throw to Conklin, the tight end. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
They'll come up now, second and nine. Back to throw. Open man here is Conklin, and he's taken down but able to slip across the 35.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
All three timeouts still at their disposal. Here's first and 10 now. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Just over 50 seconds remain. Here's second and 10. Here's Wilson. Oh, and that nearly ended it. That should have been intercepted, but he cannot corral it, and that is a lifeline there with third down coming up.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
Throwing now is Wilson. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
Partner, they've got one chance left to keep this one going. And I think for you and me, let's think along with their offensive coordinator now. Has to think back, cycle through every play of this contest, and remember what's worked and what hasn't. Because right here, he needs the best play of the game in order to keep this one alive. 57,
Here we go. It's Wilson on fourth down. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Jets first down as they manage to convert, and that'll keep the drive alive.
Now a timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game.
Two timeouts still available in this final minute. It's first and 10 now.
Now Wilson. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game.
They'll come up now. This is second and long.
Wilson to throw.
He gets it underneath to Hall.
And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line.
It drives some people crazy to see those short throws underneath. They've got to find a way to gash the defense downfield.
The Jets going to go ahead and use their final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. So on now is Greg Zuerlein in a pressure situation.
And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts.
That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. This to potentially send us to overtime. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds.
So they hadn't called on him at all until this point, but he comes through here and buries one from long range.
Yeah, that's awfully impressive because usually kickers like to get that first one out of their system in the first quarter, sort of get them into the flow of the game. But to come in this late and knock it down from long distance, give him a lot of credit.
So overtime on the horizon, barring a wild finish here as the kick's away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he returns this to the 22. First and 10, it's Robinson.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. So four quarters wasn't enough, and we are off to overtime. Don't change that dial.
So the first chance of this overtime will go to Washington as we are back underway. Taken at the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Washington offense set to take over. First and 10 here for Hal and the Commanders at their own 23. He'll get it to Robinson to begin the drive. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. Short gain there to start overtime.
Almost a tester play, wasn't it? Wanted to see if the guys on defense were going to fit the gaps the correct way, because we're in overtime. So it's not just physical tiredness out there, right? Mentally, are you still doing what you're supposed to do? And they were up to the task on that play.
And certainly fatigue on both sides of the football.
That is incomplete. Once that ball was popped in the air, you could almost hear the silence, the collective breath being held here in the stadium.
Let's be honest about it. We both came out of our chairs, didn't we? All right, anytime you see the ball in the air like that, there is that collective rise, the crowd holding its breath, and boy, oh boy, the moment of truth as it comes down. Man, that was something.
Everything magnified here in overtime. And he comes back with one complete. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. A gain of 8 there on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
I know they may want to go for this, but the smart play probably to punt it, even given the field position, right?
In a sense, you honor what they've done all game. And this is a defense that's held the score down, kept it tight, kept you right in it, and they're really jonesing for one more shot. Give it to them. Let them play defense for you and give you a better chance to win the game.
Here's Tressway now. On for a very important punt here in overtime. Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Jets offense about set to take over as they head onto the field.
Well, their defense did the job, got off the field without giving up any points. And now, Charles, all they need here is a field goal and they get the victory.
Yeah, and this is the way I love overtime. I'm one of those really, really old school guys that like sudden death right from the beginning. Well, we've got it now because any points wins the game. On defense, get a safety, a pick six, fumble return. You can win it as well. So I'm really looking forward to this series and see how both sides play it.
They'll start on the ground, Hall. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 51 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. On first down, right back to Hall. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Ball on the 39. Here's the 2nd and 8. Now what can Wilson do here in the OT? Now throw on the run, but that's going to be incomplete.
Another nice job there defensively. They've really stymied their passing attempts, and it continues in overtime.
And for them to do that, that means they've had to be cohesive on defense. Pressure in the quarterback's face, good coverage of not just the wide receivers, but the tight end, the running backs when they try and slip out, and making sure they're at the point of attack. When the ball's in the air, they get there and help force some of those incompletions.
Now Wilson, and he'll find Hall. And they stop him up short of the first down as they get him at about the 43.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Here's Thomas Morstead now. He's been terrific so far. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here.
And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there, it was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Howell and the Commanders come up now, first and 10
at their own 20-yard line.
He'll start with a give to Robinson.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. This being their second opportunity in overtime, third overall drive, see if they can settle into a rhythm.
And that's what you're looking for. Get a few first downs, move the ball downfield, have some confidence, get yourself in a spot where you can at least kick a field goal to win it. But I tell you this, if I'm the play caller, I'm looking at that part of my sheet that says playmakers. Get the ball in their hands, critical situation, now's their time.
Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Powell. Pass taken in by his big tight end.
And they work this well upfield across the 45.
To throw.
Finding Samuel. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
From just across the midfield stripe, here's a second and 7. Here's Howell.
Slings this deep from McLaurin. And this is caught. And he is in for the score. And it is absolute stunned silence here as they win it on the road in overtime. As the fans exit back out through the turnstiles, not happy looks on their faces. Feel like they probably let this one slip away at home in overtime.
I would agree with that, and their unhappiness hurts the guys at the concession stands on the way out, right? Not stopping to buy something for the kids. They just want to get home. But what a dramatic way to finish this bad boy off. I mean, this game was dramatic all the way through. That's why we got to overtime. And then to go ahead and finish it this way, the fans streaming out unhappy. But the team that came in here and won this one on the road, they sprinted to their locker room.
And speaking of buying things, dinner on you tonight, Davis.
I kind of figured that was coming.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hardworking men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. With that, we sign off from MetLife Stadium.